A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th Feb, on the front page you have the news: 37 CRPF men killed in Jammu and Kashmir suicide attack. So this was a Jaish militant who rammed explosive-laden vehicle into a bus that was part of a convoy of 70 vehicles. And in this, at least 37 CRPF personnel have been killed. Next is, Supreme Court sends Delhi power tussle case to larger bench. So this is regarding Delhi being a national capital territory, what are the powers of the chief minister and what are the powers of the governor, lieutenant governor in Delhi. So the two judges differed over control of services. So the Supreme Court bench comprising of the two judges have given a split opinion, and that is why they have referred the case to a larger bench now. Then below you have wasted effort. Half of India's waste to energy plants defunct. So this is a coverage which we have seen earlier too. So these are waste to energy plants to convert non-biodegradable waste, but half of such plants in India are defunct. So country's inability to segregate waste is already there, and these non-degradable waste to energy plants, they are also working below capacity. So this is an analysis by Center for Science and Environment. On page 5, you have this coverage about Kerala, tourism in Kerala. It says, God's own country gets back tourists after deluge of issues. So, globality returns after floods and the Nipah scare and the Sabarimala stir. So, tourism is picking up in Kerala now. Then on page 7, you have the front page news continued regarding Supreme Court verdict on Delhi. So, the Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal says, it is injustice to people of Delhi, the verdict as such. And this is regarding the Enron case. Supreme Court declines plea to close appeal in Enron case. So in this, allegations have been made of paybacks, kickbacks or corruption involving ministers and bureaucrats. So the Supreme Court has refused to entertain Maharashtra government's request for closing the appeal filed by the Center for India Trade Union in 1997 alleging corruption in the Enron deal. So it was Enron promoted Dabhol power plant in Maharashtra, which is involved in this case. Below you have Gujjar stalemate continues in Rajasthan. So Gujjars in Rajasthan are demanding reservation, and the government of Rajasthan has notified 5% reservation. Already the bill has been passed to provide 5% reservation to Gujjars and 4 other nomadic communities. So now they are studying this step taken, and the stalemate as such still continues. On the editorial page, the first editorial is auditor's account. So this is regarding CAG report on Rafael deal. So it says, the CAG report does not allay all doubts about the Rafael deal. So though it has highlighted some lacunae, it's not all out about the details with the details of Rafael. And second editorial is common and minimum. So this is regarding opposition parties which have all come together for the Lok Sabha elections, forthcoming elections. So the editorial says that opposition parties will have to make compromises to build a cohesive front and come with a common minimum program as such too. The lead article, stress points of democracy. So this is an article talking about how in the election year in India, we need to keep a sharper eye on weakening of institutions. Then next is the Karnataka model of politics. So this also we have already seen in news how in Karnataka, the two sides, the opposition and the party in power, the coalition government formed, they are trying to pull each other down. So this is criticized here actually. Then on Fridays on OPED page, you have this yes, no, it's complicated coverage. So today the question is the unemployment crisis for real? So there are three viewpoints given, yes, no, and it's complicated, which also says that the issue of underemployment is more pressing than unemployment. People are underemployed. So though on a field, for example, if two workers can work and that suffices, since there are many people who are ready to work, four people may be working. So of course their wages would also be low and the work is divided amongst them. So that is how it happens in the country when there is a lot of people who want to take up work and there is less of work. Then this is the coverage on the CAG report. The opposition leader P. Chidambaram, he says CAG report makes no sense, audit is a joke, he says, reiterating demand for joint parliamentary committee probe in on the Rafael deal. Then This is again regarding the waste to energy plants, the continuation of the front page news. Then this is CAG pulls up IAF for helicopter deal. So Comptroller Auditor General of India has pulled up the Indian Air Force for having the helicopter deal, the heavy lift and the attack helicopters which India wants in the tenders. So they have issued tenders to suit products of a particular vendor. So that is what has been alleged here. So it is Chinook and Apache helicopters of Boeing of USA which have been chosen from the evaluation process. So CAG has pulled up the Air Force in this deal. Then this is regarding the Jammu and Kashmir terrorist attack. It gives a timeline of such attacks by Jaish-e-Mohammed in JEM in Jammu and Kashmir. And this is India signs defense pact with Germany and Sweden. So India has concluded defense cooperation and security protection agreements with Germany and Sweden, the two European countries which are being visited by Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. On international page you have House passes resolution to end US support for Yemen war. So this is the House of Representatives, the lower house of USA, of the parliament, the Congress as such, in, as it is called in USA, it passed a resolution to end US support for Yemen war. So Yemen war is basically led by Saudi Arabia. So this is calling for stopping US support. Then on business page you have in rescue effort, banks to acquire majority stake in Jet. So we had seen how Jet Airways defaulted and a resolution plan for restructuring has been proposed. So this provisional resolution plan, which is led by banks, has been okayed by the board. So you can see this is a consortium of commercial banks led by State Bank of India, which will acquire a majority stake in Jet Airways. So this is the detail. Then there is no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.